today's video, I'm going to be doing back to school supply shopping. Me and my mum are just going to go to the shops right now and I'm just going to get some school supplies and things that I'll need for school. I don't want to get too much because I can obviously still use the stuff that I bought last year for school. I just need kind of basic stuff like folders and pens and pencils and stuff like that. But I will vlog it all at the shops so you guys can see what I'm getting. At the end of this video, I'm going to do a haul for you guys of everything that I got for school. I really hope you guys enjoy this video. Me and my mom are gonna go to the shops right now and let's get this video started. In the shops I have to wear this mask, so you might not be able to hear me that well, but I mean I'm just gonna wear it, so hopefully you can hear me fine. I'm gonna go to the school supply section of the shop and just get a couple things. It's kind of awkward because there are people in that aisle and it's gonna be like so awkward if I stop filming there, but yeah, I'm just gonna go and hopefully they leave that aisle soon so I can actually film and stuff. I find it like way too awkward. So I'm gonna get this pen and then it also has like the refill of the ink, so that will be pretty good. I literally always run out of these at school, so I'm definitely gonna get a pack of these. I'm gonna get the pack of two of the Tippex, and then I have highlighters at home so I don't need to get them. I'm also getting two packs of post-its, so these are the ones for like books and stuff, and then these are just big ones for writing notes and stuff like that. I'm also gonna grab some mechanical pencils because I need just like a bunch of pencils and I feel like by the end of the year I always run out of them and I like lose them, so this is just a big pack of mechanical pencils that I'm gonna buy. I also want to get a ruler, but I want one of the ones that like snaps in the middle so they're easy to put in your pencil case. I don't really see any ones here. The one that I've got at home is just like a half ruler, so it's not a full ruler, but I think it will be fine if I keep using that. So I think I've got everything that I need at this shop. I do want to order two things because I didn't get like everything that I need. Last year I had like the pink folders that I used for school and like each of my classes I put my work into those folders, but I just had two of them because that fit all of my classes, but they're kind of broken from last year. They're like all kind of ripped on the side and stuff, so I don't think I can use them again, but I'll probably just order them again because they don't have them in this shop. They did have these ones which are kind of cute, so I'm gonna use them for two of my classes probably, or just like extra papers that I need, because I know for two of my classes that I'm taking I need like a separate folder for it, if that makes sense, or it's just like not a lot of papers, so I think I'll use them for that. And yeah, I think that's it. I just need to get the folders online and then that will be all my school supply shopping done. So I'll see you guys when we get back home and just show you a little haul of everything that I got. It's kind of chaotic in the shop and I don't like filming in front of people. I find it so awkward. So yeah, I'll see you guys when we get home. So I got back from the shops a little bit ago, but I went in the pool, so that is why my hair is wet. I'm just gonna do a little haul of everything that I got and just show you everything that I bought. So the first thing that I got are these two black friction pens with the refill inks. By the end of the year, I always lose these or run out of ink, so I think it's good that I just have two pens with six ink refills. Then I bought these mechanical pencils by the brand Bic. I think that's how you say it, but they're just a bunch of different colors. There are 10 pencils in here and then they also have an eraser on the end. Then I got these two Tippexes. I usually use two in the whole year, but if I need more then I will just get more. Then I got these post-it notes and these are just like the note markers, so you can put these in like books, folders, or whatever you need to note, like not the big post-it notes. Then I got the normal size post-it notes just with a bunch of different colors. I do have post-it notes at home, but I'm almost run out with them, so I just got a new pack of post-it notes. Then I got these two school folders and I got one in pink and then one in purple. I was gonna get both pink, but they didn't have both pink, so I just got one pink and then one purple. These will only be able to fit like one of my classes because they don't have like separate pockets. And last year I had the ones that had a bunch of different pockets. I'm probably gonna reorder them because my ones like that at home are broken and they're all like ripped down the side. But I'll be able to use these for like my special classes where I only need like a couple sheets of paper. So yeah, that is everything that I got. I didn't get too much because I do have a bunch of school supplies from last year that I can obviously reuse. I really hope you guys enjoyed this little shopping slash haul vlog.
So I'm just editing this video right now, and I thought I would just add another part to this video. So basically, I just want to do some like back to school snacks, easy, simple snacks that you can take to school, or like lunch ideas, because I know a lot of schools you have to take packed lunch, or you kind of have the options, so you can like do whatever you want. But I have 5 healthy lunch slash snack ideas, so I thought I would just include it in this video and just basically make a 2-in-1 video, because all of you guys asked for different ideas, so it's kind of hard for me to do every single one, and I just think it would be fun to include that in this video because it's kind of like back to school related, kind of not supplies haul, but it's kind of like shopping because you have to shop for the food. Okay, yeah, that makes no sense, but I'm just gonna put it in this video anyway. So yeah, these are my 5 back to school snack ideas. So the first one that I have for you guys is frozen grapes. Right now we don't have grapes, unfortunately, so I can't actually show you guys me making this, but it's basically just with grapes, you freeze them and then you eat them. Pretty simple, pretty easy, and they taste really good. So that's a great snack to bring to school or just when you're on the go. The next snack idea that I have for you guys are these quick and easy muffins. Only with 3 ingredients, so it is literally the quickest thing ever. I'm gonna actually make them right now, so I'll just show you exactly what I do. They're basically just oat muffins, and the ingredients are vanilla extract, banana, and oats. But I'm just gonna half the recipe, and then if you half it, you only need 2 bananas and then 1.5 cups of oats. The first step is to preheat your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 175 degrees Celsius. By the way, my brother is blowing up a floaty, so if you can hear that in the back, then I'm sorry about that. Then I'm just taking 2 bananas, mashing them up on a plate, but you could also use a bowl. I'm just smashing up all the bananas with a fork. You don't need to add any sugar for these because there's already sugar in a banana, but if you want to add any extra sugar, then I think you can, just to make them a bit more sweet. I've mashed up all my bananas. It looks really gross. You will need a bowl just to put all the ingredients in and mix them all up. I'm just gonna take these natural oats and then put 1.5 cups of these in a bowl, and then I'm just gonna add the banana in to my oats. Then I'm gonna get 1 teaspoon of the vanilla extract. I'm adding an extra dash of sugar, but this is not part of the ingredients and you don't have to do this, but if you want a bit of a sweeter muffin, then you can do this. Then just get some kind of spoon and mix this all together until it forms kind of like a paste. I'll show you what mine looks like once I've mixed it. I've actually never made these muffins before, but I love oats and I love banana, so I think they'll taste good. This is what my little mix looks like. It kind of looks like cookie dough. And then you can also add in mix-ins of your choice. So this can be like raspberries, strawberries, chocolate chips, maybe blueberries, or just any fruit that you like. I'm gonna add chocolate chips because that sounds the best. And by the way, as you keep mixing, it gets like more, not like cookie dough, it gets more like liquidy in a way. So all the chocolate chips are now in my muffins, and I'm just spooning them into the baking tray. I just laid out these little trays because we didn't actually have a muffin tin, so I just put them on this little black sheet, and then I'm just spooning the batter into the cupcake tins, and then I will be done. So I finished putting all the batter in to my cupcakes and it made 8. All the batter is completely gone, and I'm honestly so happy that I halved the recipe because I don't know how these taste and I'm just trying them out for the first time. So if they taste bad, then I don't have to like eat all of them, if that makes sense. I'm gonna put them in the oven for 10 minutes. Our oven is again really hot, so I'm only gonna put them in for 10 minutes instead of 15. Whilst the muffins are in the oven, I'm going to continue with the second snack idea. The second snack idea that I have for you guys is a smoothie. I'm gonna show you my favorite smoothie recipe super quickly. I don't wanna make this boring, but just show you everything that I put in my smoothie. I actually really don't feel like having a smoothie right now, so I'm just gonna show you what I put in my smoothie. So if you guys want to try it out, then you can make it for yourselves. These are actually almost empty right now, but I do put in some strawberries. I would say I put in around 5 to 6. I will also put in 1 banana. Usually before I make this smoothie, I will put it in the freezer the night before, but if I forget to do that, then I will just have a normal banana and it still tastes pretty much the same. And then I just add some milk, just like a bit above the fruit, and that's everything that I do
do, I just blend it and then put it in a cup, and then you're done. That is how I make my simple, easy smoothie.
Oh, they look so good. And the chocolate's like a little bit melted on the top. I'm so excited.
I think these are actually really good. I just gave them to my family and they really like them. They're literally all gone. There's only two left. I'm gonna switch back to yesterday me saying the outro, so adios. I will see you guys for my next video, and I'm so excited to make some back to school content very soon. I'm working on a lot of fun back to school stuff, so I really hope you guys enjoy it. That is everything that I have for you guys in this video. Thank you for watching. Bye.